plan for us, a plan. And so as we walk this journey of life, we strive to follow you, to walk with you, to know your guidance and your hope, and to sing a song of faith and love for all that you have done. And so, Lord, bless us in the hearing of your word this day. May we be enriched and renewed in our faith journey. In your name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. So, we're talking about hope, right? And but not a worldly hope. For those of you who weren't here last week, and maybe it's a refresher for some of you, but we're not talking about worldly hope, like I hope it doesn't rain today, or I hope you have a great day. That's kind of a wishy-washy, maybe it'll have a great day, maybe it won't rain. It's just, you have no control over that hope. There's nothing is just, it's just a wishy-washy kind of thing, or some kind of optimism, you know, I hope you have a good day, is some kind of optimism, and wishing for something, and wanting something. Well, the kind of hope a Christian looks to is the hope that is far superior to what the world offers and the world's definition of hope, because our hope is built on God. Our hope is built on God and His promises, what He has promised in His holy word. And so our hope is built on God and on the promises that He has given us. And so hope is about believing that God is good.
All the time,
God is good. God is good, and that He does have plans for us that are for our good. Not to torment us, not to drag us down or destroy us or lay us flat out and lay us low. God has plans for good. Godly hope is about living certain and confident. Certain and confident in the divine guarantee, the godly guarantee that we can expect the goodness of God. All the time, Doris. We can expect the goodness of God all the time. And we can expect His love, His grace, God's unconditional love, all the time. And we can trust God wants the best for us. And so we heard one of my favorite scriptures, Jeremiah 29, "For I know the plans I have, says the Lord." I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. I have plans for you that are for you to prosper, plans for not to harm you, but plans to give you a hope and a future. You see, that's what God has in mind for us. God has plans to take care of us. And God will help us to flourish and grow in and with Him. And so today I want to continue this whole concept of the theme of hope by speaking about the leader of hope and why following the leader of hope, putting our confidence in Him, putting our trust in Him, putting our hope in Him, will allow Him to do exceedingly and abundantly above and beyond all that we could ever dare to imagine or dare to ask for or even dare to think about. Far beyond any prayer we could offer, far beyond any desire, thoughts, hopes, and dreams that we could create, God will give to us abundantly more than we could ever imagine. And so have you ever played Follow the Leader? How many of you have played Follow the Leader, right? You know, we played Follow the Leader, or Simon Says?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, okay. Have you ever played it with, you know, if you play these two games, you played it on the playground, or maybe you play, if you're a preschool teacher, probably played it in preschool with the kids, or in your neighborhood with the kids. But the two games are about following someone, right? Following a leader and doing what they say. And when playing Follow the Leader, it's only fun if you have a great leader, if you have a creative and energetic leader, one who keeps moving the game along, you know, keeps moving you along, right? Otherwise, you know, while they're thinking, you know, the leader's thinking, what do I want to do next? You get bored, right? And so a good and energetic leader says, you know, step over this tree stump, and then they go stepping over the tree stump, and then they run around the garage, and then they hop across the yard, and they skip around, jump over a puddle. You know, they have the leader is really getting everything going. When Plain Simon says, what happens? If you have a good leader, Plain Simon says, who's creative and energetic, you know, you do the, you know, touch the shoulders, touch the head, jump around, spin around, twirl, put your arms up, put your arms down, and I'm going to look crazy on this. I just realized this is YouTube. Hi, folks. Anyway, nobody in the congregation followed me, by the way. So anyway, but when you say Simon says do this, Simon says do that, and then you say do this, and if you do it, and Simon hasn't told you to do it, what happens? You're out. Okay, so you have to have a good leader to do all this, right? And both these games, you can play for hours and have a lot of fun if you have a good leader. You see, a leader is key, okay? It was key on the playground when we were children. It's continued to be important as we grow into our teen years that we know about leadership and our leaders. And then beyond into adulthood, it's important. A knowledgeable or inspiring coach could lead a team successfully or get you to, Maddie over here, one of our acolytes, she's running, you know, and her coach inspires her to run and do the long distance stuff. No coach could get me to do that, let me tell you. No, I don't have the stamina for that, you know? So anyway, an inspiring teacher could probably influence you to dig in deeper into another topic or subject, you know, and get you inspired in some way or inspire you to look around for a track that you're interested in as you go into your teen years and college years. A boss could be one who motivates or challenges you to do and be better at your job and encouraging you to grow beyond what you think you can do. If you have a good boss, you know, they can help you and challenge you to grow beyond what you think you can do. What is always important, what is key, is about the leadership. What is important for your life and my life is leadership. The success and pleasure and enjoyment in life that we experience has to do who and what we choose to follow. As Christians, the most important and dynamic leader we can choose to follow is Jesus. Right, Jesus Christ. We're becoming Baptist here. I like this. Okay. For the Christian, the most important and dynamic leader we can choose to follow in this world is not the teacher, not the coach, not the mentor, not the boss, not even the parent. The most important leader, the biggest decision that we make, the most significant choice that we make, it's a choice to follow God and His plan for our future and the hope that He wants to bring to our lives so that we don't have to go through life with our own agenda. Because if we go through life with our own agenda, if we go through life with our own plan, if we go through life without God as our guide, our leader, we are going to be less than happy. Many of us will be miserable. Many of us will make very poor choices much of the time, and we'll always be wanting more. Always wanting more. Our plan may not be inherently bad, but we need to remember God's plan is exceedingly, immeasurably better than anything we could conceive of. Settling for our own plan instead of submitting to God's plan, we are settling for something less than the good that God promises. If we want to live a life full of hope, the best thing that we can do is follow the leader of heaven and earth, of all creation. The best thing that we can do is turn to the leadership role of our life over to Christ Jesus through the power of the Holy Spirit. Let the Holy Spirit lead and guide our life. Let him be the guide, the person, the God we follow. Decide to follow him wholeheartedly, trusting that he has a greater plan, a better plan that we can set up in our own limited human mind, with our own limited human creativity. You see, God is the creator and the creativity in our lives. God wants us to put him first in our lives. He wants us to put our confidence and our trust in him all the time and in all things. So we all have setbacks, right? We have all made mistakes. We've all messed up a situation, a problem, a difficulty in our lives. And we have all made a mess out of something, somewhere, at some time in our lives. We have all taken detours away from God and away from his guidance and created troubles for ourselves. We've done our own thing and we've left God behind. However, as Christians, we are discovering that it is easier to have high hopes for our spiritual growth, for the growth of our families, to have high hopes for our marriage, for our finances, for our job, for our relationships, for our recreation, our rest time, when God is our leader. That's what we're discovering on the journey of faith. At least I hope you are. Remembering and trusting and living confidently that we are so important and so loved by God that he is going before us, paving the way. So important and so loved by God that he is going behind us to urge us along. That we are so important and so loved by God that he is going alongside us to be our mentor, to be our friend, to be wisdom, to be guide for our living. So when we say, when we pray, Lord, I choose to follow you. I choose to follow your lead. I believe your plan is infinitely better than my plan could ever be. When we say those words or something like that, this is trusting that God is there to lead you and to even catch you when you fall. And that's key. So we can be bold in our trust for God, because when we fall, we trust and are confident that God will be there to pick us up, to lift us, to help dust ourselves off. From Proverbs, trust in the Lord, and we heard it read this morning. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will direct your paths. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Don't lean and don't figure it all out on your own and with your own understanding, because our human understanding, our human wisdom is so limited compared to the awesome creativity of God. And so in all our ways and everything that we do, if we submit, if we let God rule in our hearts and our lives, he's going to direct our paths for the good and not for evil. Trusting in God is believing that he loves you with an everlasting love and that he is a God of goodness and grace, and that he has the power to help you and also wants to help you and will help you. So whatever you are doing, whatever you are wanting to do, whatever you are looking forward to doing, submit it to God in prayer. Submit it to God in prayer first. spend some time in prayer and think about it and talk with God about it. Because as you're thinking about it and inviting God into it and praying, you're asking for direction, right? You're asking God to direct your path, to direct your decision, to direct your choices. And then seek peace in your decisions with God. And if it feels like you have a sense of peace about it, then follow God. And remember to follow God's command, his leadership, from Joshua 1:9. This is my command, Jesus says, or God says. Be strong and courageous. Don't be afraid. Don't be discouraged. For the Lord your God goes with you wherever you go. That's a command. This is my command to you, God says. You can be strong, you can be courageous because I'm with you. You don't have to be afraid or discouraged. I'm with you. I'm going wherever you go. And I'm going to help you make good out of the junk of life. Remember, what God intends for you goes far beyond anything you can imagine. So hang on to God's hand and his leadership and never lose hope in his promises. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, help us to never lose hope in your promises, your promise that you are always with us. The promise that you will never leave us nor abandon us. The promise that you are with us and that in our discouragement and our fear, you are there. Help us to remember that you have plans for us that are for good and not to harm us or torment us or trouble us, but plans for a good life, well lived in you, an abundant life. May not always go well, but because in those darkest times, we put our trust in you, we're looking for the good out of everything. And then we also remember that no eye has seen, no mind can conceive, no ear has heard what you have in mind for those who trust you. We can't imagine. We haven't seen, we haven't heard all that you have in mind for us, but you are pouring it out little by little as we trust in you. And so, you know, there's that old adage, when we plan, God laughs. Well, sometimes that's true. We hope you're not laughing at us, but laughing with that, you know, that sadness of saying, ah, there you go again, trying to do it without me. And so, Lord, help us to do life with you. And not wait until the end and throw up our hands and say, well, I have nothing else to do except pray. Nothing else worked. We should begin with prayer, Lord. So help us to begin each day, each moment, each decision with a prayer. A simple prayer. Lord, what do you think? Lord, guide me. Lord, show me the hope that you have in mind for this future. Heavenly Father, as we come to you, we have our hope in you, our hope that you are the great physician and that you hear our prayers. And here at Holy Cross, we hear prayers being answered all the time, and how marvelous that is, because it continues to give us hope and it gives us the future lived in you. And so, Lord, we pray prayers of thanks for Ron Rogers as in his slow but sure healing finally. You have heard our prayers and you have blessed him with an improvement, and you have blessed Dorothy in her faithfulness in prayer. We pray for Judy Schiller and